As more people get the COVID-19 vaccines, fewer people are getting tested, and that may not be a good thing.
That's right. You can still get sick. CBS 2's Jasmine Viel has more on what we need to know with life after the shots.
We're going to count to 15 on one side and 15 on the other side.
Frank DeKelly, a USC music professor and composer, got his COVID test at this drive-through site in Pasadena at the First AME Church so he could go back onto campus.
I'm fully vaccinated, but USC also encourages us to get COVID tested because the vaccines are not at 100%.
Organizers at the site say they have seen a steady stream of unvaccinated and vaccinated people coming through.
Very diverse. We're getting students, we're getting young children who are going back to school, we're getting workers.
Dr. Edward Jones Lopez, an infectious disease specialist with Keck Medicine of USC, says testing is still important because we have not hit herd immunity. There are variants, and a small percentage of people who are fully vaccinated against COVID-19 will still develop the illness. LA County is working with the state to find out just how many of these breakthrough cases have happened here.
It's a very rare event, so it could still happen, obviously. But it's obviously much less likely than if you're not vaccinated.
Dr. Thomas Yadiger with Providence Cedar Sinai Tarzana Medical Center says vaccinated people should only get tested if they are concerned.
We do still get calls with patients that have symptoms, people have been exposed, but fortunately compared to a few months ago, it's significantly decreased.
In LA County, the 7-day daily average number of tests have dropped to about 66,000 compared to 90,000 at the beginning of the year. DeKelly says he'll do whatever it takes to get back to normal.
Many of my colleagues, for many of them, it's been tough. Performers especially, their livelihoods have been taken away, so it's been very difficult. And I hope that we have turned that corner.
LA County health leaders say fully vaccinated people actually should not be getting tested regularly because it could lead to more false positives. They updated the testing requirements to focus on those who work in nursing homes, just came back from an international destination, are part of an outbreak investigation, or if it's required by a business. Here in Pasadena, Jasmine Viel, CBS 2 News.